This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to do a couple of examples of synthetic division. I'll start with a fairly straightforward example, and then I'll go on to a slightly harder one. But in general, there's nothing very hard about any of this. Okay, so here's the first problem. I've got this polynomial, 2x to the third minus 5x squared minus 2x minus 3. And I want to divide that by the binomial x minus 3. Now, instead of doing this by algebraic division or polynomial division, what I'm going to do is show you how to do the synthetic division version of it. So the first thing I do is take that polynomial and just copy down the coefficients. So that's going to be a 2, a negative 5, a negative 2, and a negative 3. I'm going to put a kind of a half box around this. And outside the box, I want to put the divisor, what I'm dividing into this number. I've got this x minus 3. I'm going to disregard the x. I'm going to take the minus 3 and change the sign. So that's going to be positive 3. Now the process works like this. I bring down the first number that I have in the box. That's a 2. I write that underneath the box. Then I multiply this 3, the divisor, times the 2, that's going to be 6, and write it underneath the next number. Then I add up the two numbers in that column. Negative 5 plus 6 is a positive 1. And then I multiply again. 3 times that positive 1 is 3. And I add the two numbers in that next column. So negative 2, I wrote the 3 right underneath it, negative 2 plus 3 is once again a positive 1. I multiply, 3 times 1 is 3. I write that underneath that negative 3. I add these two numbers together. The result is a 0. I take the last number that I've got and I just put a little box around it. That would be the remainder, the 0. Okay, now we want to take this 2, 1, and 1 and convert that back into something that looks more like a polynomial. My original problem began with an x to the third. I'm going to take one power less than what I began with and put that after my first number here, after the 2. So I'm going to have 2x squared. After that, I've got a 1. I'm going to take the next descending power, which would just be x, so I would have 1x. I won't bother to write the 1. So I've got 2x squared plus x. The next descending power would be x to the 0, which is just 1. I've got a 1 here, so I've got 2x squared plus x plus 1 as my answer. This is exactly the same answer you would have gotten if you had taken the original problem and used either algebraic long division or polynomial division to get it. Okay? Now, let's look at a variation on this. Here's another problem. I've got 3x to the third minus 15x minus 2. And I'm dividing that by x plus 2. Now, you notice I go from an x to the third to an x. I don't have an x squared power. And just as with algebraic long division, we want to show have every power represented. So we're going to put in a kind of a placeholder. I'll rewrite this as 3x to the third plus 0x squared minus 15x minus 2. And now I'll just take the coefficients. So that's 3, 0, negative 15, and negative 2. I'll put my half box around it. The divisor I have here is x plus 2. I disregard the x and take the opposite of what I've got left. Instead of positive 2, I'm going to take a negative 2. And now I'll begin. I bring down that first 3. I multiply negative 2 times 3. That's going to be a negative 6. Write that underneath the next number. Add those two numbers together, the numbers in the second column, 0 and negative 6, is negative 6. I multiply. I've got negative 2 times negative 6 is positive 12. I write that in the next column, under the negative 15. Add those two numbers together and get a negative 3. And then I multiply again. I've got negative 2 times negative 3, so that's positive 6. Write that in the last column underneath the negative 2. Add those together, and I get a 4. I'm going to put a little box around that for my remainder. And now we'll take what we've got here, 3, negative 6, negative 3, and convert that back into a polynomial. So I started with with x to the third power, which means that what I'm going to have as my answer is going to begin with x to the second power. So that's going to be 3x squared minus, the next power of x would be just x, minus 6x minus 3. And if I want to show this the way I would do it with algebraic long division, I could take that remainder and write this as plus 4 over my original divisor, x plus 2. Okay? And there's your answer. It's a fairly straightforward process. If you practice this a couple of times, it becomes more or less second nature. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.